Hi everyone, in this tutorial we're gonna work on the PM2.5 and AQI, or fine particulate matter and air quality index rasters that we generated in the previous labs. We will see how we can calculate the PM2.5 for each census tract in Ohio, and also we're gonna see how we can represent our previously generated raster grids as 3D surfaces. So let's start with the census tract to calculate PM2.5 for each census tract in Ohio. First of all, we need the census tract data from the tiger line. Okay, let's open up your Google Chrome and then type tiger line, and then in the first link select tiger line shapefile, the year 2018, web interface for the year 2019 or 18. So we need census tracts, submit, and for the Ohio, download it, and after download you need to copy this file into your lab 8 folder. Paste it here and then extract it. So open up your ArcMap. So we need to load the census tract data and also both of the rasters, PM2.5 and AQI rasters we generated in lab 7. So what we're gonna do, we need to add the first connect to folder of the ArcGIS lab. So let's add both of the rasters we generated in the lab 7, AQI and PM. We also need to add the census tract that we just downloaded. So let's change the color to hollow. So this is for, so what we're gonna do is, for example, for this division, okay, for this census tract, so what is the average value of the pixels? Okay, so each pixel has a value, right? So for example, this one has the value of, so we have to uncheck this one. So for example, this one has the value of 8, but this one has a value of, so the values are very close, but you can 8.44, this one is 8.39. So what is the average value of the pixels, and also minimum and maximum value of the pixels within this district? Okay, so within this census tract. So for this purpose we have to use zonal statistics function. Open up your Arc toolbox and then spatial analysis tools. After that, find zonal and zonal statistics as table. Okay, we're gonna have the result as table. So we get the error that tool not licensed, so we need to introduce the license. So from the customize extensions, check the spatial analyst and then close, and now it works. So what is your zone data? Your zone data is the census tract, right? So you can drag and drop it here. Your zone field is the field in this census tract that can define the zone. It should be a unique value. For example, if you open up the attribute table, which one has a unique value for each zone? For example, this one, GeoID, has a unique value for each zone, and it's like census tract ID. So we use geo ID as the name of the zone, okay, as the unique value for the zone. And then your input value, first we're gonna work with the PM. And so where you want to save your output table in labs 8 folder, right here, with the name of census underscore PM 2018. Okay, save. And we're gonna ignore no data. For example, what does it mean? So in these areas we don't have the data, right? So if you want to have the data for this area, we have to use the data for the neighboring states such as Pennsylvania. So but we cannot extrapolate, so we must have the data here to, for example, here to have the particular matter for these areas. So but we don't have it, and we want to ignore the no data for these areas. So ignore no data, make sure that you check this box, ignore no data in the calculations. And what we're gonna do is that for each census tract, we're gonna calculate the minimum, maximum, and average of the pixel values for each census tract. So you can calculate a variety of statistics, such as mean, max, minimum, range, standard deviation, and so forth. So we're gonna calculate the last one, mean, max, and mean. And also you can limit your calculations to the mask if you go to the environment and then raster analysis, and after that mask to census tract. Okay, and okay. So the operation successfully done. If you open up the attribute table, you can see for each geo ID or census tract ID, we have minimum, maximum, and average of the pixel value. So it gets the pixel, it gets the minimum, maximum, and average from the pixel value. And now you can join this table to this census tract, okay, based on the geo ID. So sometimes you need, for example, you have some climate stations only for a few points, but you need to have the climate data for each division, for each census tract. First you have to use IDW to create a continuous surface, and after that zonal statistics like table. So it creates a table for each census tract, and then you join it to census tracts. That's how you can have the climate data or particular matter information to at the census tract level. Okay, so it's a very important, a very powerful tool for your analysis. And after that, and after when you join the data to this one, you can make a choroplet map, okay, instead of the zone map. So now let's talk about the second part of this lab, which is representation of raster data as 3D surface. So far we used ArcMap for making 2D maps for the entire semester, but ArcGIS desktop has another module with the name of Arcscene that is used for 3D representation and 3D analysis. So from start menu, if you go to the academic software or ArcGIS, you can find ArcScene 10.7. click on that. So the environment of ArcScene is very similar to the environment of ArcMap, but has some slight differences. It's more for making 3D maps. Okay, so here is the environment of ArcScene, and so here you can see some new buttons in ArcScene, but still we can add the data. For example, we can add the from lab 7 PM data. Okay, PM raster surface. You can see ArcScene gives us a perspective view. So using this button, navigate button, you can move your map, you can rotate your map. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is to make a 3D map instead of a 2D map. So in the arc map we had something like this, but in ArcScene we can have a 3D maps. So how we can do that? So if you right click on this raster layer and then properties, you have to go to the base heights tab. Okay, it's a new tab that is in the exists in the ArcScene. So here we need the elevation information. Okay, so how much, so each pixel, you can get the elevation data from any other sources, but we're gonna get the elevation data from the same raster, which means that the pixel values, that higher value, so they will have higher elevation. Okay, so we get the elevation from the pixel level. So pixel values that higher value, which means that R have higher PM 2.5, will be have higher elevation. So we're gonna get the elevation from the same raster. Okay, and after that you click on apply and okay, and then right click and zoom to layer. So this is the 3D map that it created, but it's not really, so we have to we have to decrease the exaggeration for this map. If you right click on the scene layer, such as it looks like the data frame, right? So, and then scene properties, in the general tab you can click on calculate from extent vertical exaggeration. So how much exaggeration has to be here for the raster. So if you click on calculate from extents, it says that the exaggeration should be, so it automatically can find the proper exaggeration for this scene. So it says that its exaggeration should be 0.08, and when you click apply and okay, so you can see that this one is kind of 3D. So it's better to increase the exaggeration. For example, if I here I can select some of these, or I can put this, for example, 15.15. Now it's more obvious for us. So let's change the background color to black, and also enable animated rotation, so it's can this map can rotate, and then apply and okay. Let's change the color of this to, for example, this one. So the areas that, let me invert this, so the areas that have higher, so you can see that it rotates. So the area that have higher pollution have higher elevation. Okay, so you can see the northeast part of the Ohio have higher pollution, and also this part. So basically these areas have higher population, but these areas have lower pollution, and you can see that, you can see the result as a 3D map. And if you double click, if you click on pan and then double click and zoom in and zoom out, you can see the pixel values. It's very cool and interesting for representation. In the advanced GIS class, you will learn how you can create cool visualizations such as animation, fly through, and extrusion. So for the vector data, this was for the raster data, but how about the vector data? So you can also create 3D maps for the vector data or shapefiles. So you will learn this stuff in the advanced GIS class.